Welcome back everyone, and in this video I'm not going to write anything. I will be just talking about some documentation which is not written by me. You can also take a look onto this directly. So whenever we talk about database inserting the data, we always have a multiple tables, so we need to manage some kind of a relationship for data integrity and all these things. So there are different kind of association in the tables, like one to one, one to many, many to one, many to many. So there are three or four set of associations we can have in our different schema models. So how should we represent them in our defining in our models? So like belongs to, which we have already seen that that pizza belongs to a user. Similarly, player belongs to a team. Okay, so what will have what will happen? So every team will have a player ID. So what it will do, it will add a team ID attribute in the player collection. So every player will, so it's like this, there will be multiple player and every player will have a one team ID. So there will be team ID attribute for each and every player. So one player will have a one team. Okay, so belongs to is actually the, which we have seen, it is adding some temporary ID, so team ID attribute to the player, which holds the primary key for the team. Okay, so it's like a team is having the primary key and player is having the foreign key. So to create a player, you need to, you must have team already created. Similarly, like a foreign key, which we are doing for company and user. So in the company, we have the primary key UUID. Okay, let's see this example. Okay, yeah. User and company. So these are the independent two different models, and here what I'm saying, user belongs to a company, so there every user will belong to a company, so it will add this foreign key company. So company will have a primary key, and in the user it will add this FK company as a different column. Okay, so in some collections we used to have one-to-one mapping, right? So one-to-one mapping means one primary key will have its one foreign key associated in the another table. So one to one way association, like project will have a one user, one project will be assigned to a one user, and one user will have a one project. In that case we can use it like this. If you wanted to use some custom key, I mean you wanted to define your own IDs, then you can do it like this: project dot has one, and a foreign key in the user will be a initiator ID. So it's a one to one. So you can see the difference between has one and belongs to. In the belongs to, it always creates the relation. So it's a one-to-one relationship can be set using has one or belongs to both. Okay, so these are just a different view of doing it. So you can go through this documentation. It is very easy to understand and all. Like player, coach and team. So every player will belong to a team. So it will add team ID will be added to a player, and every coach will have a team. So coach ID will be added to the team target model, right? So this is the difference. I mean this is the difference, that this ID is being generated, which I mean, you know, on which table this ID is going to get assigned. So here every player team ID will be added to the on player source model. Okay, whenever you do the has one, it is adding that ID to the target model. That's only the difference. So you can see in one to many association, which is important and which we need to understand properly, that what it is doing. One to many means one country can have a multiple city, but one city will belong to a one country, right? So city colon country is many to one. Many cities can belong to a single country, a country can belong to a country can have multiple cities, one city can have only one country. So it will be like this: country has many city, and the foreign key will be country code, and source key will be is code. So one key from the country will be mapped to the city, right? And which will be acting like a foreign key. So in country, there will be a country ID. Country ID will work as a foreign key in all the cities. Or you can call it is like this: city belongs to a country, where foreign key will be a country code, but it will be a multiple entries in the city. belongs to many, and so I will talk about these advanced stuff. These are not advanced, but these are the table associations, and we will see these while we are talking about the APIs, the actual real-time scenario of APIs, where we are writing the APIs and we are writing the controller. In the controller, we are actually fetching the data from these different models. Before that, we will be assigning these kind of a one-to-many, many-to-one, many-to-one associations.